Yes? Yes. Now we're going into our second block. Lots of different perspectives and looking forward to all of them. Now our first presentation is by John Ruciak, and he's the homeowner of the project we were just about to see. And John is an IT strategist currently working for the South Australian government, as well as being a board member of the South Australian Makers Incorporated and the Growing Data Foundation. This project is probably one of the first in Sustainable House Day, first CBD projects to be in Sustainable House Day. So that's quite exciting to have a project in the city to be part of this. And a lot of his improvements were also funded through the Adelaide City Council Solar Rebate program. So you'll be able to see what government action can actually do. So here we are, John.
So we bought our house in 2007. It was a we did a renovation in 2014. There was a 1970s extension built by Sam Luxton, who was an engineer at Adelaide Uni and very heavily involved in the renewable energy thing. So he completely over-engineered that extension, so we were able to use that skeleton as what we wanted to do to bring it up to sort of modern spec. It's a terrace house. It runs north south, so it's got some issues. I'll just click forward. So the key issue really here is shading and orientation and how we're going to work with that. We've still managed to put some solar hot water on, and the panels that went in as part of the last round from the Adelaide City Council grant, so it wouldn't have happened otherwise. Again, we'll probably just as the video stops, it'll show you how the shading actually works. So it's a little bit buggy, but as the sun comes over during the day, sort of the morning sun powers the PV and the afternoon sun powers the hot water for night use. There, being a streetscape, a heritage scape as well, there's no, we couldn't unfortunately put any panels on the front north face. So we're dealing with all these things, and that's why the incentive scheme is so critical for us. Some of the things we put in, skylights, we've got low power use LED, which are all connected via the Hue system. And we've also got some voice activation system too, which is nice, probably doesn't save any energy, but it amuses the children. When we did put on our extension, we used energy efficient glass to try and get some light coming into that southern aspect of the house. So as we're looking here, we're virtually looking straight north out the front of the house. Heating, we've got a wood-fired heater we've put in. That's one of the New Zealand models. It's got it's quite efficient. We need to do some finishing off there. As you can see, we need to do some lagging. We use electric blankets in the house, so you're just heating up yourself, you're not heating up the entire house. We use evaporative cooler in vent mode. In winter sometimes, if the outside temperature is warmer than the inside, then you can pump that air in using the evaporative cooler. And we have underfloor timed under tile heating in the new extension. So as we retiled, we put that system in. Judicious use of that, depending on how much power you're producing through your solar panels, is quite appropriate, I think. And the heat coming from the floor really does, it's a different sort of heat, especially in a bathroom. It's really quite nice, and hopefully it'll end up being quite efficient. Cooling, evaporative cooler, again. We've added security bars on the windows to it so we can make use of whatever breezes we do have, obviously in conjunction with the evaporative cooler as well. The use of evaporative cooler in a big stone house like this, though, really is a manual procedure. It's a lot of hands-on sort of stuff, and your judgment about how your house is working, and like we've got here some variables, the mass of the building, what the temperature is inside versus outside, what's the humidity, what's the forecast weather, and what are people doing in the house. So hopefully one day we'll be able to automate some of that sort of stuff. Cooking, when we put the when we did the extension, we actually took out the gas. We went with induction instead. We've got microwave and a normal electric oven as well. That's the extension there, and that's me checking the solar output, I think. That's the solar PV and battery. So obviously this is what we've utilised the Adelaide City Council scheme for. So again, wouldn't happen without them. So we're using LG battery, then on the right is some of the monitoring things. So obviously seeing how much energy you're using really does influence your behaviour. So monitoring is really important. Hot water is solar hot water on the western roof. It's a little bit problematic. It's backed up in winter when the fire's on, and we've got J tariff electric boost as well. Miscellaneous floorboards, no carpets. We use filtered water, in-house filtered water. We've got ice. We actually made a deliberate decision when we did the extension not to make a big open area. With a small house on a small footprint and a family of three, we really wanted to have zones where you could just jump in. And then obviously that helps with heating and cooling. You don't need to heat large open spaces. And herb garden. So what's next? We want to look at additional solar panels when we can afford it, and depending on what happens with a building development that's happening next door. I'm pretty sure I'm going to move pretty soon to a time of day electricity contract. With the evaporative, I really want to look at how if I can build a web service that really does some advice about when and where it's appropriate to turn your evaporative cooler on. That would take into account wet bulb temperature, all these sorts of variables that affect the efficiency of an evaporative system. I want to investigate how we can transfer heat through the existing evaporative ducts. I want to look at a heliostat in the southern backyard, and that's when you're basically you have a mirror that reflects the sun back into the southern aspect of the house that tracks the sun really and just sort of puts energy back into the back of the house where it's not getting any at the moment. Cat through evaporative ducts, which is something that everyone with evaporative ducts should have. Looking at external binds and looking at redoing the backyard. So yeah, if you're interested, come along and have a look. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.